A lot of hype and media attention in the NBA is around the current crop of rookies, their teams, and their potential. There are a few rookies in particular that people are more hyped about than the others, and one of them is LaMelo Ball. Even though LaMelo went third in the NBA draft, his popularity is far more than the other two players that went before him. His father made sure of that. For those of you who have been living under a rock and forgot to pay their cable bills for the last 2 years or so, LaMelo Ball is a rookie who was drafted third in this year's NBA draft and is the youngest brother of Pelicans player Lonzo Ball. His father is the infamous LaVar Ball, who seems to rub everyone the wrong way. The Ball family gained popularity a few years ago after their impressive performances in Chino Hill. Now that you're all caught up, let's talk about what other NBA players think of LaMelo Ball. Well, what do you think of LaMelo Ball? Ever since their move into the spotlight, different people have been having different opinions on the Ball family. Many of these opinions have been influenced by LaVar Ball's actions. So many people don't particularly like the family in general because LaVar always seems to put his foot in his mouth. Other people like the boys and not so much the father. The boys seem to be great kids who just want to play basketball. When Luka Doncic is an NBA player who recently shared his thoughts on LaMelo Ball. Luka is the Mavericks' young superstar who played professional basketball in Europe while he was a toddler and showed the NBA everything he learned there and more. Recently, Luka said after LaMelo and the Hornets beat the brakes off of him and the Mavericks, he is great. He had a great game tonight. I think he's going to be great in this league. When he was asked if he had any advice that he would like to give to the young LaMelo Ball, Luka said, enjoy the game. Not everyone gets a chance to play in the NBA, so enjoy the game. Some nights are going to be tough, but enjoy the game. This was an interview after their game on December 30th. In this game, LaMelo scored 22 points, had 8 boards, and 5 assists to help the Hornets to a 118-99 win over Luka's Mavericks. This opinion and advice aren't coming from out of the dark. Luka was one of the best rookies to ever play in the NBA and had a history before the NBA that is a bit similar to that of LaMelo. Luka did not play in the NCAA Division I, but instead played professional basketball overseas before entering the NBA, and this is similar to LaMelo's path to the league. So Luka knows a thing or two about being a rookie who experienced basketball at another level outside of the US. LaMelo is putting extraordinary numbers up in his rookie season, and so did Luka. Gordon Hayward loved LaMelo so much that he left the Boston Celtics to play with him on the Charlotte Hornets. Just kidding. We know Hayward didn't go to the Hornets because of LaMelo, but he did have some good things to say about him. After experiencing the impact LaMelo is having on the team and seeing how he has adjusted to the NBA, Gordon Hayward said he thinks LaMelo Ball is going to be a really good player in the NBA for a very long time. He said he's got great size. More than anything, he has great feel for the game. He's kind of like, to me, he's got the same feel as Luka, as Russ, where they just are around the ball and the ball kind of just comes to them. He continued saying, with rebounds and being able to make the right plays and always kind of being at the right position, to me, he has the same type of feel and energy for the game. I think he's going to be really good. These are some really good words coming from an NBA veteran who has played on a few other teams in the Charlotte Hornets. Remember, Gordon played in Utah for a few years before transitioning over to the Boston Celtics. So he has a fair share of young talent, including some really great young players like Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. Another teammate of LaMelo Ball shared his thoughts on the young Ball. Bismack Biyombo is the veteran big man who plays center for the Hornets. Recently, there was a viral video going around with Bismack appearing to push LaMelo away when he attempted to embrace him after a victory. Of course, we could have interpreted this video in many ways, and being the positive and thoughtful humans we are, we all assumed that Bismack was upset with LaMelo. Bismack said we are all crazy and it's nothing like that. Bismack Biyombo said, wait a minute. Bismack Biyombo. Say it out loud. Bismack Biyombo. Man, this guy's name is ballin'. Bismack Biyombo is a great name, guys. But anyway, Biyombo said LaMelo is his little man and they always have fun. During his interview, he went on to say he said to LaMelo that they have to stop playing so much because people are taking it a little too far. He said, but I think for us at the same time, we just show how close we are, you know? But again, it's my little brother, and I think we have fun, and that's the most important thing. We're continuing to grow and helping the team win, and at the end of the day, everybody's goal is to try and win a ball game. Again, being the positive and thoughtful person that I am, I want to know if that is the truth. Was this all that happened? Well, time will tell, I guess. Guys, who do you think would win if they fought for real? I've got my money on that name, Bismack Biyombo. Man, that name's cool. Lonzo Ball is LaMelo's older brother, so he should know him better than most, if not all, other NBA players. Recently, they faced off against each other on the 8th of January, and LaMelo got the dub in their first matchup. Charlotte won the game 118-110 against the Pelicans. LaMelo almost got a triple-double, scoring 12 points, grabbing 10 rebounds, and dishing out 9 dimes. Lonzo did an interview before the game, and when he was asked about LaMelo, he had this to say. We grew up together, doing the same thing, even though he's a lot younger than I am. It's a good thing to see all the hard work pay off that my dad put in with us, my family, and the hills we ran, all the times we would play on the court. One of the interviewers asked him if he had any advice for his younger brother. He did give some pretty solid pointers. Lonzo said he would tell him that the NBA is a long season full of ups and downs. Just take it one game at a time and make sure you keep getting your ice in. Other than that, he's been playing basketball his whole life. He's been with me his whole life. So it's not too many different things that I need to tell a kid like that. He's already been in the spotlight for a long time. He knows how to deal with everything. He's got a good head on his shoulders. He went on to speak about LaMelo's courage and fight, saying that he isn't afraid of anyone. He has always played up. So, we can all see that Lonzo is very proud of his brother and knows that he will be okay in the NBA based on his history in the spotlight before he came to the league. Guys, do you think this will become a Ball brother rivalry? Who do you think will get their first ring? Lonzo or LaMelo? Do you think they will ever play together on the same team and fulfill Papa's greatest dream? Well, in addition to beating Michael Jordan one-on-one. Finally, LaMelo Ball. He is an NBA player, so let's hear what he has to say about himself. He did several interviews before the NBA draft and had some pretty interesting thoughts about his draft prospects. He said that he felt like he was born for the number one draft spot. He said he feels like he is the right man for it. Granted, he is still just a boy, a very talented boy. LaMelo said, I don't look at anything like that as pressure. Like I said, it's just basketball. So being the number one pick definitely holds a lot, but I'm glad I was born for it. Recently, LaMelo became the youngest NBA player in history to record a triple-double, and his thoughts on it were very interesting. He said, I live my life, and I know what I'm capable of. So stuff like this doesn't move me like that. I know that's supposed to happen. Well, folks, there you have it. LaMelo believes that everything that's happening should happen because this is his destiny. Are we looking at this as being cocky and entitled, or is this self-motivation and personal drive? Is his father's pushy optimism rubbing off on him, or is this the way you should think? Should we be offended by how he speaks or be encouraged to go out there and be our best selves? The even bigger question is, can he live up to his own hype? Can he become more than just a great rookie? These are all questions you can argue about in the comments, but only time will tell if we have the right answers. That's going to be it for our video of what NBA players think of LaMelo Ball. Please give us a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.